So today we are going to discuss about the first year class, that is concept of business. So this is your first chapter from part A. This is the commerce theory. So in this part A, now we are going to discuss about the first lesson, that is concept of business. Concept of business. So before going into that, so all we are human beings, daily we are performing different type of activities. Why we are performing all these activities? To satisfy our wants and the desires. So for on this purpose, for the satisfaction, for satisfy our wants and desires, we daily we are performing many types of activities. So the human beings who are doing all these activities for satisfying their human wants and desires, that activities are called as human activities. Compulsory, daily he had to do something. With that only he had to earn the money. So with that only he will satisfy his wants and desires, and even luxuries also. So these human activities are divided into as a two categories. That is, first one is economic activities and the second one is non-economic activities. Now we will take into consideration of economic activities. What do you mean by economic activities? So economic activities are nothing but the activities which are performed by the human beings only for the purpose of earning money. And it doubles sampadinchadam kosam chese pannu vatnanni manam em antam, we are called as a economic activities. The activities which are performed by the human beings only for the purpose of earning money are called as economic activities. So here it will be involved, that is production, distribution and the exchange of goods and services. And especially the main motto of this economic activities is to earn the money or to earn the profits. And especially daily economic activities, daily we are going to the shopkeeper. We are buying the goods from the different type of shopkeepers. That is also, they are doing all these activities for earning money. So here the next, I am working as a teacher here. Or am I giving free service to you? No. So for that I am taking salary from the government. This is also one of the economic activities. And the next one, you can take the example of teacher. And next one, doctor. So all these members and different type of occupations. Take the example of your father. Your father is working as a farmer. I take the examples of mechanics, drivers. So all these members, they are doing different type of activities. They are engaging in the activities. Why they are doing? Especially to lead their life and to satisfy their livelihood and to earn their livelihood. For these purpose only they are doing all these activities. So now you understood, what do you mean by economic activities? The activities which are done for the purpose of only earning the money or earning the profits. They are only called as a economic activities. It is nothing but different type of occupations. What we are doing for earning money, that is only called as economic activities. And non-economic activities. So what do you mean by non-economic activities? So non-economic activities are nothing but the activities which are done by the human beings not for purpose of earning money. Not for the purpose of earning money. Only voluntary. Ishtanga. And next one, that activities it will be done for only with the affection and love and the charity. On the basis of charity only. So this is only called as a non-economic activities. So the activities which are not for the purpose of earning money, they are only called as a non-economic activities. These activities it will be done only with the voluntary purpose. So here we have taken, we can take the example of what are the examples of non-economic activities. So here your mother is cooking food daily for you. So is she taking anything for you? No, she is not expecting anything from you. That is completely it is she is doing with affection and with a love. And the next one, housewives, they are doing all the domestic works. So everything. So these all are come under the non-economic activities. So here the non-economic activities means the activities which are not done the which are not done for the purpose of earning money. They do all these non-economic activities for the purpose of only and the affection they will do all these activities. So with for self-satisfaction. I will say, but take my example only. Suppose here I am earning the, I am working as a teacher here. Suppose if I accept the salary from the government, I am taking this. Suppose the same work in the evening, if I will teach for the poor children, I didn't expect anything from them. Then it will be considered as a non-economic activity. Suppose if I am taking salary, it is called as a economic activities. Suppose if I teach something for the poor children to help them, that is, it will be come under non-economic activities. So here the main motto of economic activities is only earning money, and the non-economic activities only they will perform with the affection and the charity purpose only they will do. And next we are going to discuss about this economic activities. So here this economic activities are again classified into as three types. That is, first one is business, profession and employment. Economic activities which are performing only for the purpose of earning money, they are classified into again three types. That first one is business, profession and employment. These three are important for intermediate public examination children. You will get for the 2 marks. So here now we will discuss about the first one is, what do you mean by business? So generally every time business people, what they will say? So we are busy. So every time they will be busy and they will on 24 hour service. So we are doing business, we are busy. So in the business itself it is there. So the meaning of business is the state of being busy. The state of being busy. It's a shop or it's a company or it's a corporation. So but if you take into the definition, it is business is nothing but production, distribution, sale and exchange of goods and services with the main aim of earning profits. So what is the meaning here? Business means production, distribution, sale, exchange of goods and services for the purpose of earning profits. So business is nothing but production of, distribution, sale or exchange of goods and services with an aim to earning the profits. Same again, that's why only it is called as an economic activity. Already in the previous we discussed it, that is, economic activities are nothing but we will do for the purpose only earning money. So here business, and every time we are going for the, if anybody will keep shop or anything, what we will say, it is called as a business. So here the business is not only nothing but distribution. So here it involves production also. So production, distribution, sale or exchange of goods or services with an intention to earn the profits. That is only called as a business. And the next one, profession. So profession is nothing but which requires a specialized educational qualifications to render the services. That is only called as a profession. So which requires the specialized occupation. So here profession, the best example for profession, it is teacher and doctor, engineer and next lawyer. Because why we are telling it as specialized educational qualification, it is called as, so teacher, teacher. If you want to become a teacher, compulsory you have to require a specialized educational qualification, that is B.Ed course, that is Bachelor of Education. Specialized educational qualification should be there. And the next one, doctor. For doctor, suppose if some boy or some girl, if anybody is suffering from fever, if I give the tablet, am I called as a doctor? No. Why? Because I don't have any specialized or any other qualifications. So that's why. So here the doctor had to possess compulsory MBBS degree. And the next one, engineer. Engineers, they should also have BTech, that is Bachelor of Technology. Then they have the specialized qualifications. And the lawyers, they have to get the, that is law. They have to complete the certificate in the lawyer course. So profession is nothing but which requires the specialized educational qualifications. Then only it will be called as a profession. For the purpose of profession, they will charge some fee amount. They will collect as an amount. So here in the business, we are calling as a what? Profits. So for the profession, what he will get the amount as a fee from the clients. The amount which is expected in this profession, that amount is called as a fee from the clients. And the next one, employment. So a person who works under the another person, that is employer, for the purpose of salary, on the basis of salary, it is a contract between the two persons. The two persons here is called as employer and employee. So here, what do you mean by employer? The person who is giving the job is called as employer, and the person who are doing the job under his boss, that employer, is called as employee. So for this purpose, he will get the salary. So it is a contract between two persons to earn salary or wages. It is only called as an employee. So here economic activities are divided into as the two types, that is business, profession and employment. So what we learned about business? Business is nothing but, that is production, distribution and sale or exchange of goods and services with an aim of earning profits. That is only called as a business. In the last class, we discussed about the economic activities and non-economic activities. So already we discussed it, that is economic activities are classified into three types. That is, first one is business, profession and employment. Now we are going to discuss about the business and its characteristics. And now we will discuss about children, business characteristics. This is the important question. And you will get in public examinations 5 marks. Now we will discuss this is business characteristics. First, what do you mean by business? Business is nothing but what? Production, distribution, sale and exchange of goods and services with an aim to earn the profits. That is only called as a business. Now we will discuss each and every characteristics. Total 8 characteristics we have. In that, first one is economic activities. So in the previous class we discussed, what do you mean by economic activities? So the economic activity is nothing but the activities which are performed to earn the money or to earn the profits are called as economic activities. So here the business also, the first characteristic, economic activities. Actually, why every person will give the business? The main motto of the each person to give the business is to earn the profits and to earn the money. That's why only it is called as an economic activities. And the next to second one is deals with goods and services. So here the business, it is producing the goods with an intention to give to the consumers. So here the business it is producing the goods and services with an intention to sell to the others. So here the goods are two types. That first one is consumer goods and capital goods. So here what do you mean by consumer goods? Consumer goods are nothing but the goods which are directly used by the consumers, like us. Daily we are using different type of products from morning to till going to the bed. That first paste, brush, and next breakfast items, and next lunch items, and different type of all we are using. That directly what we are using, they are called as a consumer goods. So here I given some example, that is tea powder, bread, shoe, and everything. It will be called as a consumer goods. The products, the goods which are directly used by the consumers are called as consumer goods. And next, second one is capital goods. So what do you mean by capital goods? The goods are which are used to make the consumer goods, to make the final goods. They are only called as a capital goods. Raw products, that is best example is consumer good is here what? Shoe. So to make that good, what we have to require, that is raw material, that is leather. So here the capital good, it is called as a leather. So the goods which are used to make the consumer goods, they are called as a capital goods. And next, third one is creation of utilities. Creation of utilities. So here by dealing with, by selling and by producing and by distributing of the goods and services, it is creating four types of utilities. Four types of utilities, and you will get in your economics also forms of utilities. That is, the first one is business is creating place utility. Place utility. Actually, daily we are using a bike, that is Honda Activa. But actually, where it was made? It was made actually some other place. That is, it was made in Gujarat. Actually, it was produced in Gujarat, but here it is moving on a Karimnagar and Keshavapatnam roads. So, and how we are getting? So, like this only, that business is creating the place utility. That is, the product is reaching from the production place to consumption place. Actually, we are very far away from the production place. If business, that is distribution process, which is not there, so we did not get the product. So, like this. So, here the business, it is creating the place utility. So, here place utility means the production, the product which is reaching from production place to consumption place. So, it is possible through the business itself. And the next one, form utility. Form utility. So, it is giving the shape to the final product by producing. It is giving the final shape to the product by produce in the production process. The best example, cotton. Actually, white, it, everything, it is there. But after, in the business, in the production process, then it will be made into as a fine cloth. So, here, the product, it is changing its form from cotton to cloth. So, like this, it is creating the form utility. And next one, possession utility. Possession utilities means, possession is nothing but making own. Getting the feeling of own. But how you are getting the product? It's my own product, mean through the process of sale. By purchasing the product from the owners. From the shopkeepers. Like this, you are like this business, it is creating the possession utilities, means transferring or exchanging from one person to the other person through the process of sale. So with this, it is creating the possession utility. And the time utility. Time utility is nothing but, so it is that business, it is producing the, distributing the goods in time. In time. Suppose in the month of June, your academic year will be started. So you need compulsory what? Notebooks. So if the production, it will be started in the month of June, what will be happen? You will get in the books in the month of November. So it is very difficult to learn. So that's why, so in time that product it is giving, it is made possible only through the business. And the best example, it is umbrellas. In the rainy season we need. And the next one, rice. Producing of rice, take the example. So like this, it is providing the time utility in time by storing facilities, by storage facilities, it is creating the time utility. So these are the four utilities which are created by the business. And the next fourth characteristic is continuity. So dealing of the goods and services, dealing with the goods and services completely and continuously, it will be there. It will be a continuous process. It will not be stopped. So a single transaction is not called as. So in the last class we discussed about the economic activities and non-economic activities. So already we discussed it, that is economic activities are classified into three types. That is, first one is business, profession and employment. Now we are going to discuss about the business and its characteristics. And now we will discuss about children, business characteristics. This is the important question and you will get in public examinations 5 marks. Now we will discuss this is business characteristics. First, what do you mean by business? Business is nothing but what? Production, distribution, sale and exchange of goods and services with an aim to earn the profits. That is only called as a business. Now we will discuss each and every characteristics. Total 8 characteristics we have. In that, first one is economic activities. So in the previous only, in the previous class we discussed, what do you mean by economic activities? So the economic activity is nothing but the activities which are performed to earn the money or to earn the profits are called as economic activities. So here the business also, the first characteristic, economic activities. Actually, why every person will give the business? The main motto of the each person to give the business is to earn the profits and to earn the money. That's why only it is called as an economic activities. And the next to second one is deals with goods and services. So here the business, it is producing the goods with an intention to give to the consumers. So here the business, it is producing the goods and services with an intention to sell to the others. So here the goods are 2 types. That first one is consumer goods and capital goods. So here, what do you mean by consumer goods? Consumer goods are nothing but the goods which are directly used by the consumers, like us. Daily we are using different type of products from morning to till going to the bed. That first paste, brush and next breakfast items and next lunch items and different type of all we are using. That directly what we are using, they are called as a consumer goods. So here I have given some example, that is tea powder, bread, shoe and everything, it will be called as a consumer goods. The products, the goods which are directly used by the consumers are called as consumer goods. And next, the second one is capital goods. So what do you mean by capital goods? The goods are which are used to make the consumer goods, to make the final goods. They are only called as a capital goods. Raw products, that is best example is consumer good is here what? Shoe. So to make that good, what we have to require, that is raw material, that is leather. So here the capital good, it is called as a leather. So the goods which are used to make the consumer goods, they are called as a capital goods. And next, third one is creation of utilities. Creation of utilities. So here by dealing with, by selling and by producing and by distributing of the goods and services, it is creating 4 types of utilities, and you will get in your economics also forms of utilities. That is, first one is business is creating place utility. place utility. Actually, daily we are using a bike that is Honda Activa. But actually, where it was made? It was made actually some other place. That is, it was made in Gujarat. Actually, it was produced in Gujarat. But here it is moving on a Karimnagar and Keshobatna roads. So, and how we are getting? So, like this only, that business is creating the place utility. That is, the product is reaching from the production place to consumption place. Actually, we are very far away from the production place. If business, that is distribution process, which is not there, so we did not get the product. So, like this. So, here the business, it is creating the place utility. So, here place utility means the production, the product which is reaching from production place to consumption place. So, it is possible through the business itself. And the next one, form utility. Form utility. So, it is giving the shape to the final product by producing. It is giving the final shape to the product by produce in the production process. The best example, cotton. Actually, white, it, everything, it is there. But after, in a business, in the production process, then it will be made into as a fine cloth. So, here, the product, it is changing its form from cotton to cloth. So, like this, it is creating the form utility. And next one, possession utility. Possession utilities means, possession is nothing but making own. Getting the feeling of own. But how you are getting the product, it's my own product, mean through the process of sale, by purchasing the product from the owners, from the shopkeepers. Like this, you are like this business, it is creating the possession utilities, means transferring or exchanging from one person to the other person through the process of sale. So with this, it is creating the possession utility. And the time utility. Time utility is nothing but, so it is that business, it is producing the, distributing the goods in time. In time. Suppose in the month of June, your academic year will be started. So you need compulsory what? Notebooks. So if the production, it will be started in the month of June, what will be happen? You will get in the books in the month of November. So it is very difficult to learn. So that's why, so in time that product it is giving, it is made possible only through the business. And the best example, it is umbrellas. In the rainy season we need. And the next one, rice. Producing of rice, take the example. So like this, it is providing the time utility in time by storing facilities, by storage facilities, it is creating the time utility. So these are the four utilities which are created by the business. And the next fourth characteristic is continuity. So dealing of the goods and services, dealing with the goods and services completely. So the next point, that is fourth point, fourth characteristic is continuity. So dealing with the goods and services completely, it will be a continuous process. So not only a single transaction, it will not be called as a business. So here dealing with goods and services, it will be a long years process. It will not be stopped. So under a single transactions for the purpose of earning money. Single transaction means single exchange for the purpose of earning money is not called as a business. Take the example, take the best example. Suppose I want to, I used my two wheeler from past 5 years. I want to resell that. I want to resell that two wheeler to the other person. So I sold that two wheeler. With that, I earned profit nearly 10,000 rupees. So is it called as a business? No, I did for only once. Suppose if I do the same thing for the next continuously, that is next years, then it will be called as a business. So here the business, it will be the continuous process. A single transaction, okasar jeste profits kosam, దాన్ని మనం బిజినెస్ అని అనం. సో ఇన్ లాంగ్ ఇయర్స్ ఇట్ విల్ బి కంటిన్యూస్ అండ్ కంపల్సరీ ఇట్ షుడ్ బి ఫర్ ద పర్పస్ ఆఫ్ ఎర్నింగ్ ప్రాఫిట్ ఇన్ ద బిజినెస్ ద కంటిన్యూటీ షుడ్ బి దే కంటిన్యూస్ ప్రాసెస్ వన్స్ ఇట్ విల్ బి సోల్డ్ ఆర్ వన్స్ ఇట్ విల్ బి పర్చేస్డ్ దెన్ ఇట్ విల్ నాట్ బి కాల్డ్ యాజ్ ఎ బిజినెస్ ఇట్ షుడ్ బి హ్యాస్ టేకెన్ మెనీ ట్రాన్సాక్షన్స్ అండ్ మెనీ ఇయర్స్ దెన్ ఓన్లీ ఇట్ విల్ బి కాల్డ్ యాజ్ ఎ బిజినెస్ సో నెక్స్ట్ వన్ సేల్ ట్రాన్స్ఫర్ ఎక్స్చేంజ్ నెక్స్ట్ క్యారెక్టరిస్టిక్ ఇస్ సేల్ ట్రాన్స్ఫర్ ఎక్స్చేంజ్ So here the dealing of goods and services. So here sold or here transferred or here exchanged for only a consideration. So here consideration is nothing but a price. So price compulsory it should be involvement of money. So if you do or if you give any service compulsory he had to expect the money from then only it will be called as a business suppose if a person he cooks for his own family so here there is not involving of money or anything so then it is not called as a business suppose the same person he runs a hotel and he cooks food for the other members and if he had taken the money then it will be called as a business so here the sale transfer or exchange everything it should be in the form of our involvement with the money that free transactions free as a gift anything it should not be done and it is not called as a business and next one is profit already you know in the business definition itself it is there production distribution sale or transfer exchange of goods and services for the purpose of earning profits Profits are the rewards for the business, and profits also it's very important to the business because next year it will be continued. The business should be continued or not. It depends on the profits. Profits are very important for the survival of the business and for the growth of the business. So profits are the most important, and that business also it should be done with the profit motive, and that profits also he should earn. With a lawful, lawful means nyaya baddhanga. Then only it will be called as a business. That illegal activities like smuggling or selling of that different type of products, that is drugs. Then it is not called as a business because completely it is against and unlawful. So the profits compulsory in the business it should be done through legal ways. So the main motto of the business also compulsory it should be earning of profits because profits are useful for the survival and growth of the business. And the next one, risk and uncertainty. Risk is nothing but possibility of loss. Business already everybody knows. Every time that owner didn't get the profits, there is a possibility of loss. Also this is one of the main characteristics of the business how much it is important profit earning and at the same time he had to that owner had to our business entrepreneur had to bear the loss he had to ready to face the risk and uncertainty because there is a many reasons to get the loss what are the general reasons what will be the generally when the businessman should get loss the first one is that product when it was not sold that is changes in the fashions because every time the fashion it will be changed every 6 months so the business entrepreneurs also when they are making the product they should be updated otherwise their product it should not be sold in the market and sometimes the risk the main risk is because of the competition now you can see cell phone providers how they are giving recharge facilities So, like that, when that after coming of Jio, all the rates, the call rates and everything which were data plans, everything which was reduced because of the competition. Also, sometimes there is a possibility of loss, competition, changes in the fashions, and the next one sometimes because of the government policies also. Government also will change the rules and regulations of the business. So that's why also. So there is a possibility of loss in the business. And the next one, because of the natural calamities. Natural calamities means earthquakes, floods. So because of that also, and sometimes the theft. And the next one, robberies. And unexpected, that is now we are facing that pandemic, that corona. Because of that also, most of the business, that complete world economy was collapsed. World economy was collapsed, most of the business centers, everything it was closed. So risk, because of that, this is one of the characteristic. And the next one, business is an art as well as science. So here business is an art. Art is nothing but skill. So here the business also compulsory if the person had to possess specialized skills, because every person or any person may not get the success in the business. To get the success in the business, compulsory he had to require some skills to perform the business activities. And here the business is also called as science. Science is nothing but it is based on the truth, facts. And next one, principles. Principles. So compulsory business also is called as an science, because why? When we are producing the things, we have to observe the inputs. And the next one, when we are earning the, if we wanted to earn the profits, we have to look after the outputs also, and we have to check the quality of the products. So everything which will be involved through different type of laws and principles, LAWS, laws and principles, which should be there. So these are the 8 types of characteristics of business. Economic activity deals with goods and services, creation of utilities, continuity, sale, transfer, exchange, and next one, profit motive, and risk and uncertainty. Business is an art as well as science. This is most important question, children. This is the 5 marks compulsory will get in the public examinations.